Hey everyone, today is Monday, the 10th of September. I already wrote today's blog post about sick day gaming because I am feeling a bit under the weather. I might not look it right now, but that's because the day is yet young. I need to run out and FedEx something to my dad real quick. But aside from that, I'm intending on doing a double run of dailies in Star Trek Online today. Yesterday I did some STFs, or Special Task Force missions. I had two of the five missions I did yesterday, I think there's a mission called The Cure, and there are three space STF missions that I like to do. The Cure, where you have three nano fabrication facilities with a Borg cube on top controlling them, spitting out birds of prey, raptors, and Negvars that have been Borgified, and you need to protect the IKS Kang while you take out these production facilities. And at the very end, the Kang warps out because they've affected repairs, and you have to take out an assimilated carrier, Klingon carrier. So that mission is a lot of fun, but the optional mission is to wipe out all three fabrication facilities in less than 15 minutes. Or, well, as well as prevent the IKS Kang from dropping below 75% hull. On normal difficulty, it's really easy to keep it from dropping below 75%. The problem was, is that the second time I did it yesterday, the group I was in, there were only four of us. And, we were going really slowly for some reason. And so maybe that was my fault because I love being on picket duty, protecting the optional objective for as long as I can. Maybe it was someone else's fault for not directing their fire appropriately. I don't know. All I know is we failed the optional objective because it took more than 15 minutes to finish off all the enemies. And that's a bullshit failure point. I really think that's a bullshit failure point. If we've protected the ship for 15 minutes, it should be able to get the hell out of there, and we should win. You know, we should get the objective accomplished. The hardest thing is on Elite, making sure that ship doesn't drop down to 75% or below. You know, but I don't know. But then the other one is Infection, where you have to take out a transwarp gate that the Borg have erected over Starbase 82, and you have to destroy there are basically three stages to it. You have to destroy the little nanite things that build up the nanite transformers, then you have to destroy the nanite transformers, then you have to destroy the gate. And the optional is prevent any healing of the nanite stuff by nanite probes and nanite spheres that come through the gate. So I was running picket duty. There were five of us this time. There were five of us. I was running picket, and no one was helping me. Like, I didn't get any extra fire support from my friend, from my teammates, not friends. And so we failed the optional. There was even a point where I was like, seriously, was I the only person who cared about doing the optional? Because the option, there's no reason to not do the optional. You get free stuff. And sometimes it's pretty good free stuff. So I don't get it. Those are really the two complaints. I did Cure twice yesterday. Once I got the objective, once I didn't. I did Infection twice yesterday. Once I got it, once I didn't. And I did Kittimer Accord once. Because after I did Infection second time, I was so pissed, I just quit. I was, this is bull. So, anyways, I don't know. Today, I might do some more STFs. I do know we need, like, 60,000 dilithium. And right now, there's only, like, three of us contributing. Everybody else is, you know, obviously busy to the featured project. The next featured project is already queued up. It's some kind of history consoles about the history of the Enterprise. We've already queued it up. I don't know if it'll stick, though, if we get to the 20th and we haven't started on it. But, I mean, we have time, so we're not in too big of a rush. So, yeah, I mean, that's really all that's going on right now. I do need to, once I get back from running my errand, I want to hop into Diablo 3, check my auctions, then hop over into Stowe and do my thing. But that's really all I've got planned for today. I did some outlining scripting for my how to do assignments in the duty officer system. And while I was in the process of that, I remembered that I neglected to mention the point of the duty officer system. Well, I mean, you know, insofar as the relevance of it to the game. And so it's kind of like I made the first tutorial assuming whoever watched it knew what they were looking at already. Which is, of course, an easy fallacy. So in the second video, what I'll do is I'll break it down a little bit better. And I may wind up breaking down the assignment video into more than one part, because it's a lot of stuff to go through. So I was thinking I would talk about, first talk about the purpose of the duty officer system overall. You know, that's like just a little brief, maybe 30 seconds to a minute at most on that. I would talk about the overview page. I would then break down the entire assignments page, how to read the assignments. And then the third video would be, like where to get assignments, where, you know, how to get more duty officers. I don't know. I really don't know. I should have scripted the entire thing at once, and I didn't, because I didn't think I wanted to do the whole thing. So, it's possible what I'll wind up doing, it's always an option, is to redo the first video and do it contiguously. Just make this big, long thing and then just chop it into bits. But I don't know. I really don't know. And I dropped the remote. So, until next time, here's hoping my nose doesn't run too much today.